In this video, we're going to talk about a wiring update for our camera. We're taking the camera power button wires out from the transistor and resistor setup that we had. We're twisting those together. We were going to use a wire nut to tie those together, which is this orange thing, but we decided not to. It was too big. So we're going to solder those together just using a soldering iron and some solder. And that'll hopefully give us a instant on, and we'll be able to take our pictures much more rapidly. We were having a lot of problems with the lag and the picture taking too long. So now we're manually connecting our camera shutter, and you can see it's taking pictures right away. So we don't have to wait anymore because the power is always being fed to the camera, and we're able to take the pictures with our shutter by just controlling that shutter button. So we're taking out the transistor and resistor for the power button and reconnecting our shutter button. And so that should accelerate the time that it takes to... Now this may drain our battery faster, but at this point in time, that's okay. So we're gonna trim off a little bit of our, heat shrink. And we'll be using our heat shrink gun to protect that new joint that we've created. And we're just gonna tuck that inside Bit-zee's shell, and we won't worry too much about it because it will... We've demonstrated that it works there, so it doesn't greatly improve the how quickly the camera can take a photograph, which is important. And so we're just going to tape that end off there, and so we've got our new connection, and we'll tuck that into the shell, like I said. And so now our camera should function much more responsively than it had in the past. Right now, what we're doing is we also realized that when we wanted to get the pictures off of our camera, we couldn't connect to the camera because it's below the USB connector. The mini USB connector on the side of the camera is too low, so we weren't able to connect to the cable. So what we're going to do is modify the outer shell just a little bit of the Bit-zee so that we can get the cable to connect to the camera more easily. It looked like it would connect before, but we hadn't done it, so we're just cutting off just a little bit of the outer part of that shell, and that's going to allow us to raise up the right-hand side of the camera. Okay, so now that we've got that trimmed out just a little bit there, we can loosen the nut there on the right-hand side and move the camera up just a little bit. We'll adjust the nuts that are underneath the camera board too, to raise the camera up and make sure that it stays high enough to access our USB board, our USB port, I should say, on the camera board there. So we're just using a screwdriver to raise those support nuts that are underneath the camera up. And then we'll verify that the camera can be connected to the micro USB cable. And it can, so that's good. And so now we're just going to put our nuts back on the camera, tighten it down, and we should be good to go.